So the presentation name is How Would I Spy on Your Smartphone? And I will tell some examples about this topic. My name is Teemu Väisänen and I come from NATO CCD COA from Tallinn. Okay. So let's try this device. No. It wasn't on. Very good. First disclaimer, this presentation is product of NATO CCD COA, but it doesn't represent any opinions or policies and so on of NATO or actually either not NATO CCD COA. They are all my views or the views of the project team. Background of me. So my name is Teemu Väisänen and I am born in Sonkajärvi in Finland. If you know the competition of wife carrying world championships, it's arranged in every summer in this small town in Finland. Then I have lived in Oulu, which is kind of IT, one of the IT cities in Finland. And now I'm living in Tallinn. I came there summer 2014. I'm a PhD student at the University of Oulu and I have been working in NATO CCD and Finnish Defence Forces since July 2014 and for VTT Technical Research Center of Finland since 2005. I can say that I'm a researcher and also some kind of security op-job man. So if anyone has any questions related to security, I might be able to answer. And I have been also voluntary in some project in Finland. About NATO CCD COA, our mission is to enhance NATO's cyber defense capability, cooperation and information sharing. And we do this via research and development, consultation, education and training. We have a lot of courses and this kind of exercises like locket seals and things like this. And we have three different areas, law and policy, technology and strategy. Here are the member countries of the center. Contributing participants, there is Finland and Austria. For example, Sweden is going to maybe join in the near future. And the same information in the map. The structure. I am working in technology branch. We have also three different branches, and all of these are cooperating with each other very closely. About the program or how do we work? So NATO ACT is requesting different things like research projects and giving ideas what to research. And also the nations who are members, they also request different projects. We then select the ones what are suitable. And there is a program of work every year, and the steering committee then approves it, and the budget is selected for that. And the project that I'm going to tell, it was a request from Latvia. Flagship projects, we have locket shields, which is a technical exercise arranged every year. This year there was maybe a bit more over than 400 people participating that. It's a blue team versus red team exercise where we try to teach blue teams how to defend different kind of systems. How many of you have been somehow participating to this exercise? Okay, at least one. Then we have a SciCon conference. It's also every year in Tallinn. What about that one? Does anyone know this conference? Okay, so it's somehow similar conference to this one, but it lasts 3 days, and there is maybe maybe a bit more different topics, of course. And then the third main product, Tunnel Manual, which is a legal book. And if I understand correctly, it's the most sold cyber-related legal book. In a nutshell, it's a NATO-oriented, multinational and interdisciplinary. So background of this study. It was made last year. There are 6 authors and few helpers. And it was published in the beginning of this year. And it's in our webpage. Anyone can go there and read it. So the request was that there are high-level officials and decision makers who have to handle mobile devices and also handle sensitive information in these devices. But they don't always follow the security policies, and that causes several risks. And the purpose of the study was to find mitigation mechanisms for the risks resulting from the usage of such systems without obeying security policies. The methodology. First, we identified the actors, assets, and scenarios. We discovered the most important risks. We did risk analysis. After that, we started doing state of the art, going through all the guidelines we found and research papers, and also existing tools like mobile device management and enterprise management tools. Then we compared how these mitigation mechanisms can prevent the risks, and also presented our own countermeasures and recommendations. Actors in this study, they are high-level officials and decision makers. But on the other hand, these mitigation mechanisms might be, in the near future, be part of any common mobile devices. Assets to be protected. Sensitive data, of course, like calls, messages, documents, IPR, innovations, privacy, locations, where you are going, who are your contacts, and how do you behave. All the passwords, usernames, and so on. Transactions. Reputation. Who are your customers, and so on. All the sensors of the devices, microphone, camera, GPS. And here are the two most important threat sources: state actors and professional criminals. In addition to these, there are of course terrorists, cyber vandals, script kiddies, activists, internal actors, and so on, as also cyber researchers. But the most important ones are the state actors and professional criminals. Here are some guidelines we went through. So our proposals are not the only ones. There are already huge amount of information how to make smartphones secure? Few challenges. One is, of course, upgrading of the devices. Basically, we can see that the Android is at the moment the most sold device, and but the problem with it is that it already has a huge amount of versions, and many of them are not updated anymore. So if you have some old Android device, you won't get the update forever, basically, for that one. So are there any secure, and yeah, of course, it doesn't relate only to Android, but other operating systems also. So are there any secure smartphones? There are several, like Black Phone and Electrobits or Bittium phones, and we have seen plenty of this kind of models that claim that they are secure, and they really have been well pen tested, but we wouldn't say that they are unhackable. They have plenty of hardening mechanisms. Some of them use only open source hardware or software. They have host-based firewalls, intrusion detection systems, and so on. But always when you add some new stuff to the device, they also add new vulnerabilities. But it's not only about the device itself. So even if you make your device secure, they are using different systems and services, and the attacks can come from there. So what has been missing? There is a lack of very good mobile antivirus tools and rootkit detection tools. As also how to enforce security policies. These are pretty much at the research level at the moment. Authentication without passwords. There have been fingerprint scanners and so on, but those can be exploited and so on. But in the research world, there is a lot of very interesting ideas how to use multi-factor and adaptive and context-based authentication. So how you are, for example, walking or so on, the device can really detect from your behavior who you are and so on. The fourth bullet, world without certificate authority-based PKI, so public key infrastructure. So as we know, there is like thousands of CAs who can sign these certificates, and it just doesn't work for my opinion. There should be some other options like keyless signatures or DNS chain or some other options. And what could be added? We could protect sensitive data based on the context. So for example, based on location. So if you are not in the secure environment, you couldn't access some sensitive data from your mobile phone. Why don't we use movement sensors to generate alarms? So if I leave my phone to the table, for example, and someone takes it, why don't we raise some alarms for that? We could use secure routing. Tor networks, for example, private antennas. So if I access my company from here, for example, using public Wi-Fi's, usually the policy is that you shouldn't access anything from the public Wi-Fi's, but it would be possible to route the traffic, for example, from some of the trusted devices. As also, if we are talking about GSM or 3G networks, there are these cases where we have the base stations that can be used to spy on you. So in that cases, we could also route the information via several devices without using the untrusted base stations. Also fake passwords. So if someone gets your phone or device and enforces you to give the password. So if someone is holding a gun in my head and makes me to set up the password, I could use some fake password, and after that the attacker would see everything in the phone, but actually the information wouldn't be correct. So in this case, do you know this home alarm systems where you have a opportunity to put like fake password? So if there is a thief coming inside your house, you can actually insert the fake password and it raises the alarm, but the alarm system still goes off for the thief. So the guards can come and so on. Also, we could swap the devices and wipe also. So in some cases, in really important situations, I could just give my device to the IT support and they would wipe it and I would get new device for that day. Also, moving target defense systems. So the attacker couldn't actually use the device or get the real information from that one. And the last bullet, second last bullet. So we could buy pen testers and red team members to attack against your devices and make them secure using that way. And of course, training. So to the topic at last. How would I spy on your smartphone? Maybe the easiest approach just to get the lock pattern. I could go behind you and see it. I could use some smart attack, so I would be able to get the pattern from the screen. Or there are like tens of different ways how to get the pattern. After that, I would either steal or borrow. I would follow you as long as you leave the device somewhere at your home or office or wherever, and just log in. Install a spying app. There are lots of them in any market basically. And if you install them from the marketplaces, they are not malware, but they are like just applications. The next approach, I would get some information where you are traveling, where you are staying, and how long. I would gather information about suitable Wi-Fi access points. I could follow you previously and get the information where you are usually connecting. What are your home Wi-Fi access point names and work access point names? I would create a rogue Wi-Fi access point, use social engineering. How many of you, for example, connected to the some of the open Wi-Fi's today? Okay, so you don't even need social engineering to make you to connect to some access points. And after that, if you be able to install some, basically anything to the device, you will get in and profit. This is one example. It was presented this year. So if you buy a device from some company that is from some country. So at the moment they might have friendly relations, but in the future the seller could actually update some of the software or operating system from the device, and using that approach just to make the device look that it doesn't work or so on. Maybe the scenario is not so useful, but it could be also used by any people basically to make the device not to work, and so you would get a new device from the seller. You might have heard about Xcode, Ghost, and WireLogger, as also YeeSpecter. So in these cases, there was malicious libraries basically that the developers used, and because of that, the malware came eventually to the software or applications, and the phone didn't have to be even jailbroken. Let's skip these. So next example, I would discover the phone model. For example, making you to visit some web pages.
How would you do that?
To make you visit some web pages.
Yes. How would you make me visit some web pages?
I could send you some email, for example. It was nice to meet today, and here is my, well, social engineering, basically. If the fierce phishing email is, for example, interesting enough, most likely you would visit it. No?
Like, I don't know, any IT security person would not read some strange email, especially on some computer.
Yeah, okay.
I just want to add, when you will receive the email, thank you for the conference and participation. Don't be afraid to click on the link to download the presentations or see the video.
I've copied all the links that I need.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. In that case, I would maybe follow you and try to see what phone you are using.
Okay.
And what applications you might have. I would try to discover what interface you use. Do you have Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, or are you just using LTE or other communication ways? I would buy some 0 days or use suitable exploits and attack via these. I could, if you are using any social media sites or so on, I could first go to your friends or contacts and maybe come from that way. Or the last one, I would indirectly force you to use certain devices or operating systems or software, some protocols and services. If you have enough resources, you can do this. Like we know. So open questions. Only public references were used, so we don't know what is the reality at the moment. We didn't concentrate on insider threats. They are not likely when we are talking about high level officials and decision makers, but of course they are possible. There are cases where There have been insiders also in that level. Some of the hardening mechanisms will make the digital forensic more difficult. And it also relates to this insider threat. So if the official is doing something malicious, it might be more difficult to find that out. And also when we add all these mobile device management or EMMs or other ways to secure the device, we always create the risks by giving the same interface to the adversaries. All right. I think I'm on time.
Yeah, you absolutely
very,
are.
Very good.
Yeah. Questions? Yeah, yes. Sure, please.
Can you repeat?
I understand that there is some third-party tool needed to have a fake password for phone, yeah? If you give your phone to attacker, yeah? Could you give some example? Is there some trusted open source software for...
To get the passwords?
No.
I think he's talking about the fake passport which you told about this alarm.
Yes.
It's coming off, coming on, then you could not type.
I don't know any tools yet. So that was one of our idea that we should add to the devices opportunity to use fake passwords.
Is there some free tools also available? Like
I don't know. So that was our idea.
This is a business idea for you.
Business idea.
More questions? Yeah, please.
You mentioned antivirus for Android. Do your research show that it is necessary to everyday use or only very specifically some highly official?
In this research, we found out that there is huge problem with antivirus products because they just use too much resources and they don't even give the safety enough, so it's very easy to bypass them. Just modify a little bit the malware, and the product doesn't find it out. Sorry, no. I don't have no. Sorry.
This is classified information. Okay. I have actually one question. Which type of phone you are using?
I'm using Nokia.
Okay.
Lumia.
Okay. So this is more secure than those what you currently.
I don't know. Maybe it's not so. Maybe no one wants to attack this because these are not used so much.
Okay. And one more maybe question. Maybe.
But as you can see, I use tape here.
Yeah.
I don't want
this is first level of security. Yeah. One more question and very short. What do you think about the sandboxing and containerization of information for data security? No, if we use some kind of tools for that.
Yes, it's actually one of the good ideas. So there were phone models already a few years ago that used virtualization and sandboxing. But back then, the problem was that it took just too much resources and the battery died very fast. But today, it's coming back, and we are gonna see phone models where virtualization and sandboxing is used very soon, or even if the first ones might already be in the market.
Okay.
Yeah, but we are talking like a different kind of virtualization, so like really putting a totally new virtual machine inside.
But it's actually putting a new virtual machine inside every time it starts a new process.
Yes, but it's like different type of, yeah.
Timo, I think you will be all day here somewhere, so yes. Basically if you have more questions to get more detailed answers, please do that. I want to thank you for the presentation. My team reminded me that I need to give a thank you gift from us. Thank you for that.
Thank you.